So hi everyone, and welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to part 2 of the video on SRE 2410. And in this portion, in this video, we'll be dealing with the appendices. So there are a total of 7 appendices as a part of this standard, and we'll be dealing with the key points of each of these appendices. So the first one, for appendix 1, deals with illustration of an engagement letter. So here they have given the engagement letter for the interim review, and the key points here are they have identified the financials which will be reviewed by the auditor, and the addressee would be the board of directors. This is an engagement agreement between the auditor and the board of directors of the entity. And they have identified the standard under which this review would be performed. And this would be a case of sample language, or the language which will be used in their auditing report. So that particular language or the conclusion para, that would be put in the engagement letter. This depends on the engagement to engagement, whether the auditor will necessarily put it or not. I am not very sure of that. And the conclusion would be that we look forward to cooperation from your staff. And another fact is, this is coming from SA 210 itself, that it will be effective for future years unless terminated or superseded. So this is a sample engagement letter between the auditor and the entity. And appendix 2 deals with what are the types of analytical procedures which the auditor is going to perform as part of the interim review. So this particular appendix is very important from the exam point of view, and there are questions which repeatedly come from this particular appendix. And there are not many points, it's just about 5 to 6 points divided into 3 buckets, and it's pretty easy to remember. So I have drawn a small chart here wherein you can easily remember all the points that are given in the above appendix. So it's current data versus prior period, current data versus what was anticipated or budgeted, and current financial data versus non-financial data. And for this, the best example would be a case of payroll. So payroll cost and the number of employees in the company, whether they are increasing in the same manner or whether there has been a big disturbance in that. That could be one example for this. And the current data versus the expectation which was set by the auditor based on his procedures. And the last point would be current data of this entity versus its peers, that is the competitors in the industry. And the next bucket would be relationship between the different elements of the financials. That is, it could be financial versus non-financial data, and it could be the ratio analysis which is performed, say gross profit margin or net profit margin and such things. So it's just a relationship between the different elements of the financials. And the last point is disaggregated data. And disaggregation, the level of disaggregation is given here, or the basis of disaggregation is given here. So these are the three buckets which you can remember, and write all the 7 or 8 points that are given as part of this appendix. And appendix 3 is dealing with management representation letter. So here it's addressed to the auditor, and it is given by the entity's board of directors. And this is the addressee and the person who is issuing is just the reverse of the engagement letter, because in the engagement letter the auditor is addressing to the board. Here the board is addressing to the auditor of the entity. So they have given what are the responsibilities which they take, and what are the representations which they are making to the auditor. And if you want this format or the representation in a little more detail, you can refer SA 580, where they have given other formats or illustrations as well. So in appendix 4, they deal with a sample example of the auditor's review report. So So this is a plain review report. There is nothing which is very special regarding this review report. They have just identified the financials and they have said that they have done the review as per SRE 2410, and no opinion is expressed, rather it's a conclusion. And if you look at the conclusion which is given, it is a negative form of expression. Nothing has come to our attention that causes us to believe that it does not give a true and fair view. So it is negative plus negative will be positive. So in this case, it is implied that they didn't find any misstatement that is material enough. But it is given in a negative form since a reasonable level of assurance was not obtained, but it was a very limited level or moderate level of assurance that they have obtained. And for this particular point, which says true and fair view, we'll have to refer para 43i of this standard. So let me show that to you. So it's coming from here, para 43i. which tells about the general purpose financial statements which are prepared and the review report based on those general purpose financials. And para 43J talks about a conclusion for all other aspects. It is not prepared in all material respects in accordance with the financial reporting framework. So if you look at para 43 I and J, these are very similar to this would refer to a fair presentation framework, and this is very similar to a compliance framework. And the same also gives in case of the conclusion also. Here it talks about not give a true and fair view, that is it, there is nothing which proscribes this from giving a true and fair view. So it is giving a true and fair view. And the next point is coming from para 43J, which talks about not prepared in all material respects in accordance with the framework. So this is again negative plus negative. Nothing has come to our attention and not prepared. So it is indirectly saying that it is prepared in accordance with the framework. So this is more like a compliance framework, and the other one is similar to a fair presentation framework. Now we deal with review report which is qualified based on the departure from the framework. So this is appendix 5, and the reason for qualification is because there is a departure from the applicable financial reporting framework. And we directly jump to basis for qualified conclusion paragraph. Here they have stated the reason which they have found as material for them to qualify the conclusion, and the fact that it is a material but not pervasive enough. And so with the exception of this matter, everything else is giving a true and fair view. So it is a qualified conclusion. Same holds good for a compliance framework as well. The matter is the same thing, and the opinion or the conclusion which is given here is not prepared in all material respects and nothing has come to our attention. So it's again that it's prepared in all material respects in accordance with the framework. And appendix 6 talks about a case for qualification based on some limitation of scope which is not imposed by the management. And we jump to the basis for qualified conclusion paragraph here. And if you look at the basis for qualified conclusion, they have given that they were unable to complete their review because the records were not available with the management. So it is a limitation on scope but not imposed by the management. Since they deem it to be material enough, the conclusion is qualified in the case. And other financial information, this is similar to a compliance framework, and nothing has come to our attention that it is not prepared in accordance with the framework, which means that it is prepared in accordance with the framework. But they've used the language except for because of the reason that they were unable to obtain the records for that. And the last appendix is a case of expression of an adverse conclusion for departure from the financial reporting framework. And this is a case where the departure is material and pervasive. And the reason which they have stated here is the entity has ceased to consolidate the financials with its subsidiaries. And since this is very material and pervasive as well, the auditor is expressing an adverse conclusion here. This is a true and fair view, which means it's a fair presentation framework. And here, in case of a compliance framework, that it is not prepared in all material respects in accordance with the framework. Here it's not a negative plus negative, but it is just a single negative which has been used, that it is not prepared. They have not used the term, nothing has come to our attention. So it is directly a negative conclusion which is expressed. So with that, we have covered all the 7 appendices of the standard, and with that we have also come to an end of SRE 2410. So you can have a look at the first video where we have discussed on the 15 points which are key points of the standard, and in this video we have discussed on the appendices of the standard. So I hope you gained something out of watching this video, and thank you for watching.